this yogi, Virendra yogi, a wonderful person, a self-believing, a very confident, a very bold and courageous person, getting inspiration from the world best, the gurus and the teachers, Swami Vivekananda, Buddha, Jesus, they are my gurus, the wisest men, the greatest teachers. And all of us has taught us, believe in yourself, have courage in yourself, have conviction in yourself that you are not born ordinary. You are like any great human being who graced this planet Earth. All these great people, they are very strong-minded, resolutely willed, steadfastly holding to their inner conviction, and they thought that everything is possible. The word impossible is found on a dictionary of fools. Brave men, they dream, desire, plan, and achieve everything whatever they wanted. If you want some of the examples, I'm very happy to give you. Buddha wanted stainless beauty and absolute peace of mind and free from all worries, anxieties, fret and self-pity. He meditated, contemplated years together. He paid the price for this precious discovery. The greatest discovery Buddha made, which was very scientific, whose philosophy is totally based on cause and effect, sowing and reaping, and he got it. Another example, you can see Copernicus. He wanted to see the multiplicity of the universe and he found it. Columbus, a brave heart, wanted to discover a new land and he got it. My idol and my brave, I can say him, the inspiration and courage, Abraham Lincoln, dream, desire to abolish slavery, and he did it. Emancipation proclamation, he did it. Anybody who dreamed and desired, cherished with a burning passion, which become obsession of his life, they all were always crowned with success. Beloved friends, these examples I have given you, but there are millions more examples. Let's count. Wright brothers wanted aeroplane. Edison wanted this electric light, incandescent light, he got it. Henry Ford wanted to pave the entire earth with self-propelled automobile, he got it. Everyone gets what he wants and dreams and desires. Now, beloved friends, I can tell you a small verse. Lives of great men all remind us, we can make our life sublime and departing leave behind us footprints on the sands of time. Yes, footprints on the sands of time. We can become hero too. We can become great too. Yes, it's possible. That is possible. But simultaneously, you see what the poet says. The heights by great men reached and kept were not attained by a sudden flight, but they, while their companions slept, were toiling upward in the night. Man, there is nothing, a truth on earth, that something for nothing. The law of compensation is always working, law of karma, cause and effect. There are two things. There is one effort, another is result. So the strength of your effort is going to be the measure of your result. That's very, very important. And in that circumstances, you can see that I have put so much hard work, I am doing so great, still I am not better than others. Forget about this. You have to compete with yourself. All are not created equal. There is always a difference from person to person. I am a tennis player and I always give example from tennis legends. You see, there are 3-4 superstars. Federer won 20th Grand Slam, recently Australian Open. Nadal won his French Open. It was his 15th, 10-time French Open. Then another Djokovic won also 12. Pete Sampras won 40. You see, they are different people with different drive, determination, commitment and daring. But they are different levels. Here also one thing is very, very important. All are not destined to become similar. They can be different. So you don't worry. What you can do your best. You are only responsible for yourself. And you have to compete with yourself. Budgeting your time, money and energy. Concentrating, dedicating, committing. Resolutely willed, strong-minded, steadfastly holding your inner conviction. That you will always do your best. You will always do your best. Totally absorbed in your meditative state of mind. Focusing your all resources. Your brain, your body, your brain, the faculty and talents. Everything will back you because these are resources. These are the different equipments which will help you to become a great man. Because God has given everyone a wonderful mind. Whatever the mind can conceive and believe, the mind can give you. And you have to believe in yourself that you can do it too. You can do it too, man. But the courage must come from the soul within. The man must furnish the will to win. So figure it out yourself, my friend. Figure it out yourself, my friends. You were born with all the assets and equipments and facilities and resources which all great men were endowed and blessed with. So you have to simply set your goal, your definite purpose. Anything and everything is possible for it. It depends on your thinking capacity, on your imaginative capacity. If you want great, you can become great. If you want to be medium, mediocre, you can be also. Because it only thinks how much you dare to think. My one of the best friend, Michelangelo, said, it is not frustrating that we dream too big and we could not achieve it. It is only pity that we dream too small and we get it. Yes, dream big, man. Had Wright brothers not dreamt of flying, we could be all moving on these ordinary, you know, the horses and buggies. If Henry Ford had not dreamt of the self-propelled automobile, we could not have the best supercars today. Believe in yourself. Be very happy. Learn from addition. Keep on trying. One process, one procedure, failing, another procedure, another method, another attempt. You have some weakness. Try to overcome your weakness. Overcome your weakness. I gave you one example of a very promising child, my own daughter Vishnu Vishesh. We dream for her to be the world best. 10 Wimbledon. 9 Wimbledon for women is the record. I dream she will win 10 Wimbledon. She tried her best initially. She was a child, she didn't have all the drive, dedication, commitment and passion. But today she has. Everyone is asking, what's her age? What's her age? But I tell you, ask Federer, what's your age? He's more than 35 and he's winning. Serena Williams asks, what's your age? She's 37 and she has won the record 23 Grand Slam. Age is not a factor, man. If you maintain a perfect physical health, well-conditioned body, very strong and fit, then age is nothing to do. So I inspire even my daughter Vishnu, who says, beta, my beloved child, don't worry for your age. Worry for your sharp edge of the brain, the confidence, the belief and faith, the courage, the determination, the willpower, the perseverance, the persistence, and always believing that you can do better than others. That's why I dreamed for you 10 Wimbledon. And I dreamed for you 25 Grand Slam. Because 24 is record of, you know, the Margaret court, 24. Serena has won 23. 25th I dreamed for you, my daughter. You can do it. Don't worry for anything else. Just work. Practice. Everything. Serve, volley, everything, and you are going to be great. Never allow fear and doubt come to your mind. Because that will dampen your spirit. Don't think anything is uncertain. Everything is certain. You can become. But patience, faith, believe in yourself, believe in your mother, Dr. Vandana, who has sacrificed everything on her life. She resigned from the class one job in NMDC. She was the best executive. She could be anybody great today. Still she has 5 years service. That time, you know, very rich salary. Your father, this Virendra Yogi, retired, financially crunched. Panbhusan, Dr. G.V. Krishna is now sponsoring my everything. He has sponsored you, Vishnu Vishesh. Come on, Vishnu Vishesh. Arise, awake, and stop not till you reach your goal. You can do it. Work very hard, physically, mentally, spiritually. Connect yourself with infinite intelligence. Believe in himself. Believe in yourself. Trust in himself. Trust in yourself. Trust in your mastermind and his partner. Your mama, and then your dad, and then Ravi, and then your coach Praveen, Nagraj, and even your coach was Emilio Sanchez Vicario. Trust all these people. But first, believe in yourself. Believe in yourself. Never think that you cannot become better than others. You can become. When I told Vishnu Vishesh means it represents all my children, all my daughters and all my sons of all over the world. It is a symbolic name, Vishnu Vishesh. It represents one child. All children are my children. I am the father of every human being. Every children are my children. I am not their biological father, but intellectual father, guru. Guru is also like a father. God is also our father. May God bless you. Believe in yourself. Work very hard. And always right before you, wherever you are. The Gita, most inspiring. Aphorism. Karmanyevadhikaraste ma phalesu kadachana. Karmanyevadhikaraste ma phalesu kadachana. Ma karmaphal hetubhu mate sangosta karmani. Your duty to perform your task with full dedication, passion and devotion. The full measure of your devotion, commitment. Always believing that you will do the best and never to worry about the result. Result is not your control. You want a mango tree, you have to sow the seed of a mango and create all the conditions favorable so that the mango fruit is coming. But you have not to worry whether mango fruit will come or not. Yes, this is the natural law. This spiritual law, it will always work. Like the gravitational law always works. So you should worry only what you can do about it. What you can do about it, what my friend Napoleon Hill says. When he asks the great four, when you are in crisis, when you are in problem, what do you do? Then Ford said, you do what you can do. You cannot do something what you cannot do. And once you do what you can do, slowly the mountain melts. It becomes water. Come on! Believe in yourself. You can do what you want. 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 But be hero like me. This yogi, Virendra Yogi. I believe in myself, man. I am Alexander the Great. I am Napoleon the Great. I am God's true son. I cannot bend his head. God, you will feel proud of me. Rabindranath Tagore, you will feel proud of me. Subhas Bose will feel proud of me. Vivekananda will be proud of me. I belong to that category, that gene. Every children of India and every children of the world belong to that great gene. Believe in yourself. Never fear. Never doubt. Never hesitate. Never condemn yourself. Let me tell you what John Jay Engel said. Master of human destinies I am. Fame, love and fortune waits at my gate, footsteps. Cities and fields as walk. I penetrate desert and sea and passing by hovels and mart and palaces soon or late. Those sleeping wake, those feasting rise before I turn away. This is the hour of fate. And those who follow me reach every estate, conquer every foe and save date. But those who doubt and hesitate, condemned to failure, penury or no, they seek me in vain, they uselessly implore. I answer not, I return no more. Beloved friends, your opportunity is there. Grab this opportunity strongly, with a lot of passion and love, and you are going to be great. God bless you, and thank you very much. And thank you very much. I love you, man. You love yourself. You are the only person who can create your destiny. I can't do anything for you. You do your